नाउ डॉक्टर रिगार्डिंग टॉन्सिलेक्टमी आपका विचार क्या है? आई डोंट नो ग्रिसल सिंड्रोम वॉज इट गिवन समथिंग ओके हाँ बट आई थिंक समथिंग एल्स इज डायरेक्टली विजिबल एज एन आंसर व्हाट इज योर आंसर क्वेश्चन नंबर 46 इज इट ऑनलाइन ओके ओह एक्सेप्ट भी है क्या आई डिडंट प्रिपेयर टुडे फॉर एन एक्सेप्ट सो आई ओनली प्रिपेयर फॉर वन अमंग देम Oh, except was there. Right, right. In that case, obstructive sleep apnea is the common indication, which is true. In fact, in the modern time, the most common indication is obstructive sleep apnea, at least in the West. So, anyway, I'll come back on the remaining options. I didn't do a cross-reference. Now, pregnant women... Hearing loss worsened. That was the case study given. What is your answer? Yes, that's good. I think easiest question. This is very interesting. This is we are going to fight on this. Steroid is not recommended in. You mean post fungal sinusitis surgery? You want to say? और कुछ विचार है क्या क्रॉनिक राइनोसाइनसाइटिस पोस्ट सर्जरी वाज इट योर आंसर इन द एग्जाम गुड गेस 48 फाहिमा हासन आल्सो इज एग्रीइंग विद बी शैल वी से बी इज द करेक्ट आंसर वन लाउड क्लैप प्लीज फॉर यू टू रिमेंबर I leave to you in the literature. I am not listening. Arey, you are a big crowd. That's good. So, doctor, post-anthracoinal surgery. For anthracoinal polyps, primarily it is the surgery followed by steroids. Even chronic rhinosinusitis also, if polyps are there, steroids are indicated. Otherwise, surgery alone. That is the funda. Examiner is trying to check. Ethmoidal polyps, we do that, even post-fungal also. Now doctor, which is not a part of the ethmoid bone? Simplest question in the world. If you know difference between a bone, ligament, cartilage, tendon, that is enough to clear the AIIMS exam. So, now doctor, what is the correct match among this? Glaucoma, glaucoma, glaucoma. You don't get time to revise ophthalmology. Only read 5 topics at least for me. Glaucoma, cataract, retinal detachment, not conjunctivitis. Conjunctivitis, they won't ask much except if you know what is bacterial, what is viral enough. Right? Then what else? But vernal conjunctivitis they ask. That's good. And national control program. Definitely 5 questions will come from these 5 topics. Still you have time to think about retinoblastoma, retinitis pigmentosa, retinal detachment, vitreous hemorrhage. Oh, they are all toppers in the class will read. Not for every weak heart. Who has much beautiful things to do in the world? Yes. Brimonidine. What was the alternative answers? I am listening. Everyone is proposing B. Very good. You also prepared very well for the today's session. Brimonidine, clonidine, they are all what? Alpha 2 receptor agonists in the brain. They decrease the sympathetic outflow. Right? So that's how they decrease the aqueous humor production in the ciliary body. Now, doctor. Degenerative myopia. What is true about it? One loud answer. Is it more common in females or males? Females. That is very well known. Question number 51. Fahima, Shailu, Anita, Matthews, everyone is pronouncing it as A. That's good. Refractory error in pathological myopia will be more than 6 diopters. 6 diopters. Now, osteosarcoma is the most common secondary malignancy of retinoblastoma. It goes without saying. This is a very tough topic. Pterygium may itna level. Question is too high to expect. Pterygium, pseudopterygium. How will you differentiate? If you pass a probe, it can pass underneath the pterygium, then it is called as, that is a feature of pseudopterygium, basically. So what is your answer? Beautiful. Recurrence after the bare scleral technique would be around 30% is what need to be remembered. And it is not the UV, but it is the UV but not infrared rays. This is another, agar angreji padna hai to ye answer kar sakte. Lens protein ko kya hoga budape mein? Why people get cataract? So answer, placard. More insoluble, obviously less soluble. Why both need to be given? To check whether you know antonyms, synonyms in Renin-Martin English. So question number 54, right. Under national blindness control program, how well Dr. Agarwal has done the cataract surgery in a district hospital will be known by Gupta. Now tell me, what will Gupta will be doing? Which type? Active? Passive? Matlab Agarwal ko nahi bolke Gupta jaake check karega secretly? Follow up. Question number 55. Neha is proposing C. Please give one loud clap, doctor, to Neha. Loud clap. Not C. I am not committing C. Sorry. Any other answer? What is left over? Basically, there are under national prevention program of control of blindness, there are SSUs, Sentinel Surveillance Units, which are operational under the collaboration between Community Medicine Department and the Department of Ophthalmology. So what is the basic function of an SSU? To monitor the ophthalmic morbidity and cataract surgery and also the visual outcome after the surgery. Wo Delhi mein air conditioned room mein baith ke bahut bade bade yojana karte hain and we are supposed to remember what they are doing. Community level is not an easy job, doctor. Treating one patient with malaria is a small thing. Treating a tribe from dying like a genocide in the hands of Plasmodium is a challenge. As a, some of you, if you really are ambitious, you can take community medicine, let me honestly tell you. Of course, once I joined in community medicine in JIPA before getting in general medicine, so we used to have a very, very humorous professor. Aapko shaadi hua kya? I said, kyun sir, mai to final year mein hi bhaag ke shaadi kar liya. There is no problem for me. Magar aap kyun puch rahe sir? Then he said, agar shaadi nahi huye to koi ladki nahi dega. Pehla shaadi karke community medicine mein join ho jao. Oh, that is the reason, sir. No problem, sir. I am already married, already having a child when I am in husbandship. So he said that, why, sir? But there is one more risk for you. Boliye, sir. Your wife can divorce. That risk is there. I told him, are aap kya baat kar rahe hai, sir? Aapka bibi to aapke saath hai. Aap MD preventive medicine ka professor hai, atna. Then he said, at least she will divorce bol ke maine SPM liya. SPM lene ke baad bhi nahi chhod rahe. So that is a community medicine talk. So doctor, if you are really ambitious, you want to bring an impact in the society, and ultimately when we become super duper specialists, we all want to contribute something that is more possible with community medicine. If you get a seat, don't leave. Even if you are unmarried or you are married also. That is the same rule applies. Now, glaucomatous damage basically involves which layer, doctor? There is only one layer we know. But don't say rods and cones. There is something else. Guesswork. Ganglion cell layer. Beautiful. Broadly placed long collagen fibers with wide spacing. I don't know. Because our Vizag student wrote broadly spaced. Another people wrote wide spacing. I included everything. I mean, broadly placed means widely spaced only. What is your answer? Diaphragm. You mean one fiber and other fiber is like a fishnet? Or is it compact for us, for it to lift the thoracic lungs? Question number 57. Very good. Durga, Fahima, everyone guessed it as cornea. Which is right? Normally cornea, it is compact. That is the reason it maintains transparency. But the typical degenerated cornea, if you take as a person ages, the broadly placed collagen fibers are the classical feature. I am not sure that is what I understood from what I read in Google. So now doctor, this is a simple question. One question regularly comes on band shaped keratopathy. What is your answer? Calcium. Pediatrician, why will he call an ophthalmologist? If there is a retinopathy of prematurity. So when will you define it? Huh? 28 weeks or 2300 grams? Very good, 28 weeks. Indirect ophthalmoscopy, direct, another very predictable question. What is your answer? If you do this question also wrong, you are not ready for this All India. You are too early for next All India. Jaldi bolo. It's a real inverted image, not a virtual erect image is what you need to basically remember. In females, if there are orbital metastases, what is the most common cause? In males, what is the most common cause? Breast cancer and lung cancer. They are the two important malignancies which are notorious to have ocular metastasis is what need to be remembered. That's right. There is generally AIIMS may, some years they give more number of physiology questions like that, but state entrance mate is a very fixed pattern. Every department want to give their own measure of questions. So that is the reason, since 19 departments give in state entrance, there will be 19 into 1, at least 20 questions having a key error. That's what I am like to tell you. So give me an answer. Narrow angle glaucoma? Atropine. Even a school going kid will answer this. Optic atrophy. Do you think out of the 5, which option was not there? Choroidal vasculopathy was not there. But 5 options can't be there, no? Question number 63. Optic neuritis was not there. Very good. Then what is your answer then? If choroidal vasculopathy is there, that should become the answer. Because Cravo, methanol poisoning, retinitis pigmentosa, all of them are known to lead to development of optic atrophy. I leave to you the literature. This is an example of an optic atrophy, same time bony corpuscles. So what is the combination? Retinitis pigmentosa showing optic atrophy. Then I leave the literature for you, causes of optic atrophy. Now bilateral proptosis. In the ophthalmology we discussed totally in our Monday to Friday session around 60 topics, which is available in the online video library. Proptosis, if you take last 20 papers of AIIMS, more or less 70-80% of times you will have a question on proptosis. Jaldi bolo, what's your answer? 64. Anita proposes rhabdomyosarcoma. A reasonable guess. Reasonable guess, yeah. What do you like to say, doctor? Neha says rhabdomyosarcoma, but Fahima says neuroblastoma. All our guns are saying neuroblastoma from the last dose. That's good. Neuroblastoma typically will lead to the development of bilateral proptosis. Of course, there is a list of causes for unilateral and bilateral proptosis, two different lists. So what is meant by Q test? Propose an answer. First time you came to know, no? Because you are prepared for T test. You are prepared for chi square. Examiner asks chi triangle. So what is your answer? Fahima proposes C, Anita proposes D. Why? You are all so attracted about D. What is there in D? Means of more than two groups. But what is the main problem of any data analysis? Outliers. What is meant by an outlier, doctor? Basically, an outlier, if you are having certain values like potassium, what is the value of potassium do you expect in a ward generally? Most of the patients, when you are doing morning rounds, 4, 4.2, somebody will have 4.3, 4.1, like that. Suddenly you found a guy who is having 10, but he is drinking a cup of coffee absolutely comfortable. So outliers are those extreme values which you have not expected in a given data. Most of the people die by 70. You found a 120-year-old guy one day in the OP. He is an outlier. So because of that 120-year-old guy, there can be a pollution of the data which you are analyzing. Or somebody died at 20. Because of that, if you included him in the study, the study data may get affected, the age related values. Q test is basically to identify those statistical outliers, and in order to basically eliminate them, you do the Dixon's Q test. Now, question number 66. Give me an answer, doctor. Oh, lot of people give me a different argument. Up to one standard deviation, it is how much? 68. How did you come to 34? You all thought, some of you thought 34. No, what is the reason of thinking 34, doctor? You subtracted 99.7 from 68. Mean, the amount of population between the mean value and the mean plus one standard deviation value. He asked to subtract it and tell me. That's right, it is 68.3. From that we need to subtract 50%, you mean to say? Correct, doctor. Positive side or negative side, if you go one standard deviation, it will be in a normal distribution, 68.3% of population fall into that. That minus 50% at the mean value, did he ask or what? Now, how did you reach 34? First, O below.
Actually,
Okay. Oh, you thought the two sides of the mean milai to 68.3. How is it possible, doctor? Mean is there. Mean ka two sides agar milai to 68.3. People will be sitting in that. Or from the starting point it is. Oh, you mean to say 68.3 minus 50 jo bhi aaya usko into 2 kiya. Oh, acha acha, the spread is 68.3, so divided by 2. Oh, this also looks reasonable logic. Since around the mean value, two sides milai to 68.3 hai, so one side is divided by 2, you want to say. Oh, okay, okay, okay. Maybe, because the complete English of the question, agar pade to, maybe that is the meaning of that. Looks good, looks. Then we need to revise the answer if that is the logic of examiner also. 34. Good, good. What is the another controversial answer? You are all agreeing with 50%, no? Thank God. Any 50 by 2 or 50 into 2 divided by 3, nothing is there. Okay. That's good. this you answered, doctor. If you used your English, you will go wrong. Dekhenge. Catch up? You all want to say catch up? Nobody want to say keep up? Mop up, follow up, sure, very good. Then your English is too good. But Fahima is proposing keep up. Rajni is proposing follow up. We have few outliers. Durga is proposing mop up. Not bad, not bad. The fun of attending coaching is not to learn from the teacher. What is there to learn from teacher? Nothing. Suddenly you ask another two questions, he will be surprised. You will be surprised that he knows very few things. The whole fun of attending a coaching or a mock test is to find how our classmates are pathologically thinking, are super physiologically answering. So that is the main purpose. Catch up. What is meant by, okay, now you should tell me, what is the difference between follow up and catch up? I'll close the explanation. Anybody want to say catch up kya hota hai, follow up kya hota hai? English only. Aapko ek achha skin problem wala patient mil gaya. Throughout your life, he will be coming regularly. Every winter, he will have a skin problem. So, what kind of patient you got? A good follow-up patient. Right? Whereas, you got a patient who is having a brainstem stroke. You have to catch up the patient, otherwise he will die. One round of vaccination if you do, you call it as, in the preventive medicine terminology, measles catch-up campaign. If you happen to do periodic event, like every 3 to 5 years if you are doing, then you call it as follow-up campaign. That is the fundamental difference between the two. Now regarding polio, what is true, doctor? Was it could not eradicate or could eradicate? Is it true only, no? Right. So last case was noted on 13th January 2011. That means to get MD seat, as much passion you read Harrison, you should read The Hindu, Indian Express, Times of India, and regularly watch Kaun Banega Karodpati. to become PG-pati. So, what is the RDA? Was, did they ask RDA of folic acid? No, no, only iodine. 220 was not there. Okay, the nearest relative is 250. Chalo. What, that is your answer? Question number 70. Yeah. Basically, doctor, according to Shastra, RDA of iodine is 220 per day for pregnant women, 290 micrograms for breastfeeding women, and during the pregnancy it increases to 220 from the normal RDA, which is 150 micrograms. So three values you need to remember: 150, 220 and 290. Indoor pollution does not lead to pollution. May you read a lot of things, particulate pollutants. Have you expected indoor pollution? What is the most indoor pollution that you suffer from? Watching TV, which destroys the brain. Yeah, what is your answer? B or C? Our stalwarts are all differing. Even online also, Tara, Sai, Fahima, everyone are saying C. Except Sandeep is proposing, Priya and Aruna are proposing D. They thought pneumonias don't occur if the child is in the home. Not really, doctor. Stillbirths are one of the low birth weight, tuberculosis, ischemic heart disease, nasopharyngeal and laryngeal cancers. Epstein-Barr virus to remember is easy. Indoor pollution may laryngeal cancer, will you remember? Very difficult. COPD, in fact, COPD 54% of times. Husband will be smoking, wife will be pilging. That's right. And 2% from lung cancer. There is no neurological complication. Screw feed technology, already rapid sand filters, slow sand filters, so sab ho gaya. Naya naya questions are coming. Is it any old question? Very difficult. First time only you came to know. Now you need to answer it. Unscrew it. Come on, give a confident answer. We get an answer as C. You mean not for pathological waste. You want to say? Question number 72, even Fahima and Anju, they are all proposing for non-pathological waste. Roll back malaria may, what is not included, doctor? First time? Oh. You mean preventive medicine guys will be discovering new insecticides, sir? That research job is not part of what a community medicine guy can do, no? For that matter, only a research guy can do. And lot of money is involved in researching. You have to kill 1 million insects. For that, you require 10 million funding. That should pass through various departments. What is not included? Very good. Durga is proposing D. I too thought. Remaining three looks very convincing. National immunization schedule at 5 years. DT, only DT booster. Very good. I told you, no, Janani Suraksha Yojana or Rashtriya Swasthya Bhima Yojana, all insurance policies this time. Swasthya Bhima Yojana is insurance policy. Insurance basically. What do you know about it? Some confident answer. Neha and Sai are proposing applicable only for BPL. BPL means Okay. Below poverty line, eh? Okay, okay. Huh. A? Very good. And the patient doesn't pay anything except the registration fees. Unlike regular insurance policies, what will they tell? You die rich and all your children will enjoy it. Maybe your wife will have a better second marriage with all that insurance money. There were some movies also taken on that. That is not the problem here. You don't pay anything. Then how much 30,000 per family member means families together love to die. Entire family 30,000. In the modern day of the prices, doctor, 30,000 ke mein kya milega? Kuch bhi nahi milega. Entire family that too. Agar wo the below poverty line belongs to Amjad Ali Khan, his son Akbar, Barbar, Birbal, sabko dena padega. So, but 3 of his son already are earning. They are not wasting time in preparing for MD entrance. They are already working in a mechanic shop. One is running a hotel. So, Amjad Khan does not need any problem. So, not for the each family member, entire family. It is not for OP basis, only for IP basis. That's the idea. Doubts of, aapka answer kya hai? Our ESI topper. If you did wrong, I will tell to not give you the special quota. A? Beautiful. Excellent, doctor. How much is the funeral benefit? Only Gaud is going to answer. No, no, don't be carried away by their point. 5,000 only? Remaining 5,000 doctors are taking or what? No idea? Oh, but ESA Act, let me tell you, state MD entrance may, every time it will be asked, right? So question number 76, very good. You should remember, at present 7/8 share of the prescribed ceiling is borne by ESI, 1/8 by the state government. Funeral expense 10,000 rupees will be given, not 50,000. Then contribution payable by the employer is 4.75. Tomorrow you are going to run top nursing homes employing 10 dayas, another 10 ANMs and 20 nurses. So you must know a few regulations also, how to take care of your people. Such a wonderful scheme, ESI. There is no upper ceiling limit. You even bypass surgery will be done without paying anything under ESI Act. But the employer must insist of making all his employees participate in ESI, which is not a screening modality. What is your answer? Are we doing CA-125 the way we are doing PSA? Are we doing? No, no. In fact, ovarian cancer, by the time it is detected, it will be in a stage 2 or stage 3. Ovarian cancer. There is no role for any tumor marker screening under any national guidelines of any nation. I think answer should be A. Baba Baba black sheep, have you any wool? Which color that belongs to? Biomedical waste, color coding, which class they belong to? Tip of the nose, you need to carry it, otherwise get a nasal implant on some high yield facts. We will also come up with a chip like that. So what is your answer? Common sense answer bolo. Red is common sense answer, but common sense answers uncommonly will be right. There is a green, you mean to say answer is green. insecticide hai ya nahi, wo bolo, then I will tell the right answer. Question number 78. Durga says, see, our friend is saying green, your answer? But in the original exam to hai na, Anita proposes D, Shanti says B, Rahul says A. Ho gaya na? C koi bola kya? Durga already said C, all outliers are done. Now, black, why black? Category 10 will be highly poisonous insecticides. Black is basically used for category 5, 9 and 10. That's the reason black becomes the answer. There is no green coding available also, no? He is asking the color of the logo. Logo color on the highly hazardous insecticides. I think generally biomedical waste, that word is not there, you mean to say. Okay, we will revise that. There may be some logo, it may be having color, Google will be having all that. We will come back. Google is the biggest professor. Which disease is not post disaster? I mean, that is not failing in AIIMS disaster, generally natural disaster, which disease does not come? Who like to propose some confident answer? Even Prashant from Delhi is also saying that logo color is asked, not the color of the bag. Agreed. Everyone is proposing leishmaniasis. Any other famous wrong answer? Rickets. Only two issues. Even a school child knows acute respiratory infections and leptospirosis. Right? Doctor, don't be angry with me. I am telling leishmania is wrong because there is literature which says leishmaniasis included among those diseases which health authorities will be alerted whenever there is any outbreak. So that's the reason rickettsia become the answer. How much money we spend in protecting ourselves from the attack by our neighboring country versus taking care of our own health? Point. You don't propose your demands, right? What is really allocated? Wo bolna. Question number 80. Durga, Anita, Prashant, Davangiri, everyone is saying 0.12. Are we going too slow? You will remember it forever. That's the reason I am going little slow. Otherwise, because if we know what world is thinking, who said C? But I am not even convinced about option C. Why? Economic survey says India spends 4.1% on GDP, doctor. That is in the year 2012. 2011 May it was 3.9%. Matlab 0.39 to 0.41. I don't know whether examiner want to know 2013 wala statistics. The matching figure is, it can't be lesser than what we were spending earlier. 4.1 means kitna? Zero? 0.04, no? 0.04. It can't be 0.005. That too, we are going to have election shortly. Itna kam kare to mushkil ho jata. Question number 80. America is spending 17%. right? So, of course, in America, your job is over once you made somebody pregnant. Country will take care of the delivery. After that, everything will be taken care of. The social security of the kid, everything. In India, it is not like that. There is no money even to get married also. We will check this, doctor. This numerical is perplexing. Terrible question. Under 5 mortality, OB millions may. Under 5 mortality is generally the mortality calculated per 1000 childbirth. But examiner is not happy. He knows you are very intelligent students. Last year, NEET beat was sub disturb ho gaye. Is birth bahut padh ke aate. So, isliye examiner want to know millions mein kitna hai. Jaldi bolo. 81. Anita says C. Shanti says B. Davangiri says C. Koi A bolo. Did we give an answer? Oh, we didn't give an answer. Because, doctor, the childbirth in India, childbirth, matlab under 5, fell from 2.5 million in 2001 to 1.5 million in 2012. Why these statistics are important? Later on, MD Pediatrics, DCH, wo lene ke liye thoda important hai. Out of this 1.5 million, more than half occurred in neonates and the remaining 0.7 million occurred from 1 to 59 months. That means 5 years. Ab bolo, isme any corresponding figure hai kya? Koi bhi dekhe to 68, 10, 12 hai. So, we need to check. Was there any question given on, you are sure that it is, these values are same which examiner gave? Oh, but million is how much? That's right. Which is a dynamic stabilizer of the shoulder joint, doctor? Rotator cuff. Static restraints, dynamic restraints. That is how the shoulder joint stability is decided. Supracundylar fracture. Oh, Prashant is adding another twist to the question. It is a global burden that is asked. Is it? Or only India? Global burden. Then it will be much higher. No, because we are surrounded by Somalia-like countries on one side. And there are some countries where babies birth itself is people will give money to the mothers. There are some countries with a negative growth rate. Where somebody become pregnant, they pay as a dividend. Then I will check global burden, I will check and come back on that. What is your answer? Supracondylar fracture? Neurological involvement is most of the times transitory, is what you need to remember. All the remaining stay, 86 to 100% of times nerve injuries are all neuropraxis. They will recover very well. This is an interesting question. Normal hand grip, able to hold pen, movements preserved except dorsiflexion. No sensory loss. Which nerve is involved? Only 3 nerves, no doctor. One radial, one median, one ulnar. Already pen test is normal hand grip means which is involved? Normal. And able to hold pen. Pen holding is median. Hand grip is ulnar. And dorsiflexion you require radial nerve. Radial nerve branches, posterior interosseous nerve. Simple. 12-year-old obese, what is your diagnosis? Obese patient comes to the with painful limp means only painful limp in orthopedics is 2 conditions. Perthes, slipped capital femoral epiphysis. Slipped capital femoral epiphysis is very common obese male child. So what is your answer? As an investigation, question number 85. Matthews is proposing MRI. Ultrasound. Should not be is there. Oh, sorry, doctor. What it should be, I thought. Sorry. Then I thought X-ray pelvis. X-ray pelvis, then in that case, I did not do research on if it is, it should not be, what should be the answer. But anyway, X-ray is what we do. Remaining options, I will check it and confirm. I thought should be. Child is exposed, brought to emergency, gallows traction. Shaft of femur, right? So, state MD entrance is easy. Straight, one gun is kept, gallows is where? If you don't answer, you are on gallows. A pura story deke, ultimately asking what is gallows. That is called USMLization of Indian exams. So, shaft of femur. Causes of the club foot. Except was there, Okay, arthrogryposis, polio, spina bifida, all of them are implicated. I don't think they have given CTEV. Club foot in a newborn. Then it will not be. There is no congenital polio. Luckily. Okay. Good point. We will make a correction on the online. Yeah. 4-year-old with a fever and mass with periosteal reaction and destruction of bone. What is the diagnosis in your mind in a pediatric bone tumor? Which presents like osteomyelitis, like clinical picture. Evings, that's good. Where was the mass? Anything committed? Shaft. Diaphyseal tumor is Evings. There are only two things which are shaft, diaphysis. Benign tumors may? Osteoid osteoma, malignant tumors may, Ewing sarcoma is what you need to remember. Chalo, what is your answer? Question number 88. Gold standard for diagnosis of the Ewing's is bone biopsy. Bone biopsy is what you need to do, and that in turn will give you a courage to do the further part of the treatment. Right. I think the next question. Okay. Bag and mask ventilation, I don't know what were the options. It's not an except question, right? Except was there? I don't know, but one of the options was 450 ml is the size of the ambu, which is a true statement. Then one more thing you need to know, doctor. Bag volume is how much generally? 200 to 750, usually more than 450 ml. Bilateral calf swelling means pseudo hypertrophy. Where do you see? As the age progresses, there will be deposition of fatty tissue into the muscle. That's the reason CPK levels will start in Duchenne's muscular dystrophy falling down as the patient proceeds, is what you need to remember. Dystrophin. 6 weeks old with fever and cough 3 days, now respiratory rate 48 per minute. Beautiful question. No chest indrawing, ronchi are there. What is the wrong statement about it? Beautiful. To call that the child is having pneumonia, how much respiratory rate is required? It depends on the age. Very important. Typically, it is greater than 16 children under 2 months old. And he being given a 6 weeks means 2 months se chota hai. 50 in children 2 months to 1 year. And greater than 40 in the child between 1 to 5 years. According to age, to remember respiratory rate, doctor, let me tell you. Many questions previously were asked on the same issue. Do you know according to the respiratory rate to qualify it as pneumonia or not? According to the age, what is the appropriate respiratory rate? Very common question. Abdominal mass for metastatic workup. Which tumor? Neuroblastoma. Easy question. Definitely one question on Wilms or neuroblastoma. Without that, there is no pediatric paper. Newborn frothing of saliva. right at birth only. No. Was it given newborn with frothing of saliva? Was it given? Closing the eyes, there is only one diagnosis. First, second, third is only that diagnosis. What is that? Esophageal atresia. There is no other condition which lead to frothing at birth. Unless there is an esophageal atresia as a blowing pouch which is causing the regurgitation leading to frothing of the saliva in a newborn baby. Classical question. Right, doctor? Now, why? Sinusitis is there. Aspiration will be there, no? Associated feature. See, when there is an esophageal atresia, he is also aspirating. Aspiration is the predisposing factor. Now, least common cause of the neonatal sepsis, what is your answer, doctor? What is the answer? Acinetobacter. I think question is good, but option would have been a little more dramatic, Pseudomonas or something. Neonate with seizures on day 2, beautiful question. Day 2 seizures, what is the common thing that comes to mind? Hypocalcemia, what will you discover on any of these investigations? What is the complication you expect if seizures on day 1, day 2? Much? You think a little more detailed. You said HIE, na? Hypoxic ischemic encephalopathy and intraventricular hemorrhage could be one of the important causes. So that's the reason, doctor. Bedside ultrasonography. Typically, doctor, in a well baby on day 2 or 3, if at all there is any seizures, you think of subarachnoid hemorrhage. Otherwise, intraventricular hemorrhage, if there is in a term neonate, if there are any seizures on day 2. So, most of the times if you do cranial ultrasonography, you can be able to delineate and rule out the presence of intraventricular hemorrhage. Beautiful question. Synodic spell, what is not used? Fundamental question. Calcium chloride? Phenylephrine, was there instead of adrenaline? No issue. But was it anybody's answer, phenylephrine? Very good. Any other? Chalo. Tetralogy of Fallot-Mae, why there is a cyanosis first of all? Right? If you know that, you will answer it any time of your life. If you don't know that, you will only be guessing. I'll tell you very simple. Right ventricle ke andar blood hai doctor, pulmonic stenosis hai, tough mein, right? Same time there is a overriding aorta. Aorta is saying, hey, right ventricular blood, that fellow pulmonic stenosis, a ruffian, please come down, I am more easy for you to get into. Then what will right ventricular blood will do? So the overriding aorta, it will tend to go into the systemic circulation, that is the artery, aorta. Will right to left or left to right, which will lead to development of cyanosis? Right to left will lead to cyanosis. So what is the way we can avoid this? Either you should make the pulmonic stenosis to relax, that is relieve the spasm at the level of the pulmonary root, that you need to do. Or what is the other option available? Make even the aorta also have high pressure. Then the right ventricle blood will think, at least this wife called pulmonary artery is little better. Khana khilane mein thoda der karega. The other wife who is called aorta is much worse. She won't even let to come inside the house also. So it is better to go with the regular situation called as pulmonary artery. So phenylephrine, or you give any agent like adrenaline, which increases the systemic vascular resistance and make aorta impenetrable for the right ventricular blood, and make the right ventricular blood redirected back into pulmonary artery, will decrease the right to left shunt, and that's how the cyanosis will come down. So we give oxygen, we give morphine, we give adrenaline or phenylephrine, the important way by which we treat why we give morphine. Morphine relieves that spasm at the root of the pulmonary artery, is what need to be basically remembered. Then one more important thing is, we correct the acidosis, as rightly said by Durga, with sodium bicarbonate. Why? Acidosis also is a predisposing factor for the pulmonary arterial root spasm. So you relieve that, then right ventricle can easily negotiate the blood into the pulmonary artery. So that is the idea, doctor. Now let's go to the next question. Phototherapy, may what is the important determining factor? Commit some answer. Question number 97. Yeah, question number 97. Huh? Are we radiating a baby in giving phototherapy? We are not giving a radiotherapy, right? But irradiation dose was there in the options. We don't remember, sir, by the time already exam was over. Yeah, skin pigment will decide, serum bilirubin at the time of initiation will definitely decide, and basically the type of beam and the way we place the beam, how close we place that beam, they all are also the determining factors. Efficacy of the phototherapy is what need to be remembered. This is the question I am waiting since long time. Juvenile CML, is it the same question? How does it differ from the adult CML? Without a question on leukemia, lymphoma, there is no question paper. That's a deal. Jaldi bolo. First time, how many heard juvenile myelomonocytic leukemia exists? JMML. You know that already. I know, you are all brilliant students. Jaldi bolo. Then in that case, you must tell remaining points also. 98. Anita, Manoj, Sai, everyone is proposing A. If A is true, then why can't B can be true? So A agar nahi hai, toh B bhi nahi hoga. So better is, between C and D you have a chance to choose. Bahut mushkil hai, sir. Can it be second most common malignancy? If it is, then we would have read it long back, is what we will think. First most common only to remember is Dikkadore. So where will you remember second most? It is second most common malignancy. And what are the differences, doctor? Tomorrow's exam it will come. That's the reason you need to know. No Philadelphia chromosome, no blast crisis in case of the juvenile CMML, peripheral blood monocytosis will be very high. So that is what you need to basically remember. And also very important question, lot of times asked on juvenile CML. HbF, fetal hemoglobin, typically increases, is a very classical finding. You don't find 922, but you will find monosomy of the 7 is an important chromosomal abnormality. Now comes our subject, general medicine. Let us talk about it, doctor.